हेलो, कहाँ पे है? तो जल्दी तैयार होना यार, कितना टाइम लेती है। हाँ, जल्दी आ, जल्दी आ, 10 मिनट में आ जल्दी से। ओह गॉड, आई एम टेलिंग यू माय सिस्टर इज एक्सट्रीमली लेजी। वेल, आई जस्ट वोक हर अप एंड टोल्ड हर दैट इट्स राखी, गेट अप, इट्स टाइम फॉर अस टू यू नो सेलिब्रेट एंड डू द Ceremony. So people all across the world who don't know what Rakhi is also called Raksha Bandhan. It's a festival celebrated in India where a sister ties a sacred thread on a brother's wrist and the brother promises to keep her safe throughout her life. Well, it's not a big promise if you love a sister. You would anyway take care of her, but this is just to ensure. It's a festival. So well, what I'm going to do today is I have to gift her something in return. So today I'm going to cook a special dish for her and that's going to be my gift for her. So what I'm going to cook is chocolate kheer. Kheer is a rice dish but my sister loves chocolate. So I'm going to blend a rice kheer with chocolate and make a chocolate kheer. So let's start this. Let's start Raksha Bandhan and a very happy Rakhi to all the viewers. So first thing we need for a rice kheer is milk. We need 1 liter of milk for half a cup of rice. So what I've done is I have washed and soaked the rice for 30 minutes. Not more than 30, but 30 is enough. There are two ways of making a rice kheer. One is that you could soak the rice for 30 minutes. The other is you could dry roast it or you could roast it in ghee for 5 to 7 minutes. So I have soaked it in water for 30 minutes. It's done. If you are going to make this recipe, I am very sure you don't want to cook this kheer for an hour. So you're going to cheat. For your sister, you can cheat. So what we're going to do is, we're going to cook this in a pressure cooker partially and partially on open fire so they won't know that we've cheated. Switch on the gas. Add 1 liter of milk to this. Now we're going to add half a cup of rice which we have soaked for 30 minutes. Obviously, if you have the time, you can cook this kheer on open fire. You don't need to use a pressure cooker. That's the real way to do it. But I'm giving you a shortcut. Let the rice mix with the milk. Because we don't want it to stick to the bottom. So once you've given a nice mix, we'll shut the cooker and let it pressure cook. That's it. Now, we're going to shut the lid and cook this till we get one whistle. I think a whistle is going to come. There we go. Okay, this is about it. Now you put it on sim for 2 minutes and then shut it off. It's done. So I've shut the gas off. Time to chop the almonds. We need almond slivers. So I'll show you another cool technique to take out perfect slivers. So you take almond. Now it won't stand because it's round. So you chop the bottom like this. Okay? And now it will stand. And now you can chop longer slivers of almond. Okay, look at this. So you get longer cigars, longer slivers. It's pretty cool. So the next step is, now we can open this. Perfect. Now if you look at this, it looks pretty cool. Now we'll take a deep saucepan and put our kheer in this. All the rice comes out. So if you notice, the rice is 80% cooked. The rest 20% will cook in the pan. But kesar ki kasar abhi baki hai. So kesar. So right time to be adding great quality kesar from Kashmir. Few strands. Let me tell you, we're adding kesar here not for the color. Chocolate is going to take all the color away, but we're adding kesar here for the beautiful aroma. And I will suggest whenever you buy kesar like this from Kashmir, keep it in a locker. Very important. So you have to ensure that once the kheer gets a boil, then you only cook it on sim. You don't have to cook it rapidly, otherwise milk and rice will not come together. So now let's melt the chocolate. To make your life easier, if you have a microwave, it's easiest. 2 minutes to melt the chocolate. So what you have to do is, you have to break these chocolate pieces as evenly as possible, and then we put them in the microwave. Setting it at 1 minute 30 seconds. If it needs more, we put about 30 seconds more. Oh, it's going to be. But it ideally needs 1 minute 30 seconds to 2 minutes. Let's check the heat. It's coming together. Another 10 minutes, it should be done. So, pressure cook it for 1 whistle. Another 2 minutes in the cooker. Switch it off. After that, open it up and cook it here for 15 minutes. So out of which 10 are done, 5 will be after we add the cocoa, malt powder and our dark chocolate. Chocolate is melted, only 1 minute is needed, not more than that. See, it looks okay. If you will keep it more than this, it will be burnt. Now comes the time, but before we add our dark chocolate in this, let's quickly add 1.5 teaspoons of cocoa powder, 2 big spoons of malt powder. And now we're going to add our, after we give this a stir and look at the changing colors of the heat already because of the cocoa and the malt powder. Well, some people prefer for their ghee to be thin. So it totally depends on you. If you like your ghee thin, you can add more milk and keep it thinner. But I like my ghee to be absolutely thick and creamy. So well, there goes our creamy dark chocolate. Look at this. Wow. Well, my sister is a dark chocolate fan and well, she's in for a treat today. And surprise, she doesn't know how to cook. The dark chocolate is mixed nicely with our rice. First, let's add 1 TBSP. And what happens is, after you add sugar, sugar will again make it slightly thin. Because that's what sugar does. The crystals melt and makes it slightly thinner. Do a taste check. I think it is perfect. Our kheer is cooked. Now time for final presentation and final steps. We already have our almond cigars or slivers ready. A bit of elaichi powder on the top, optional. You can avoid it because we already added saffron. But I will add just like the tiniest pinch. Look at this. How much is it? Just for slight elaichi cardamom essence. This is done. Let's do a presentation. So now we need to present our kheer in a heart shape pose. So the kheer is nice, thick, the rice is cooked. So well, these almonds not only add good flavor, but they add a good color to the dish, to which prove this dish is very done. Ladies and gentlemen, Surbhi. Surbhi, say hi to all the viewers.
Hi.
Great. See, that was a better man. Not very shy after all. So, Well, the meetha is going to be replaced with my dish here. So, the chocolate kheer goes in the rakhi thali. So, this is a Raksha Bandhan thali with a traditional tikka, roli, and this is a sacred coconut that they give also for some reasons, not asking what are the reasons. Great. So there you go. Thank you. Okay then. In normal circumstances, a brother would touch his sister's feet, but I don't do that. Great. Thank you. Now we're going to change the... Okay.
Yes.
Yeah, so traditionally a sister is supposed to feed a brother, but we're going to change the tradition there. Of course, it's chocolate kheer. There's no way I'm going to have this first. There you go, Surbhi. Happy Rakhi. Okay, bye. Happy Rakhi.
What one?
No, no, this is mine. Mm-hmm. Well, it's Rakhi. I shouldn't be mean. Okay, Surbhi. Oh, wow. Ah. My bangs. Thank you.
It's wonderful.
Mm. Well, we all know it's good. Chef Saranch has made it. There are no doubts about this. Thank you, Surbhi.
Bye-bye.
I'm supposed to finish the show, so I'll take care of all this.
Happy Rakhi.
Thank you. So well, guys, that was my sister Surbhi. She's off. She likes to do animation. Does all the graphic stuff. I don't know anything about. But what I know about is Taufik, he is excellent. Happy Rakhi to all of you. Why don't you tag your sisters? Make a hashtag, tag me, make chocolate kheer, and send me your pics. It'll be fun. Twitter, Instagram, Facebook. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, well, this is a perfect day to do that. Happy Rakhi. See you guys.